So I've been getting a lot of questions about this root password hack that people have been talking about in the news. It's not as dangerous as it sounds, because the important thing to realize is somebody needs physical access to your Mac. They need to be sitting down at your keyboard for this to get them anywhere. So unless somebody breaks into your house or steals your MacBook or something like that, then it's not an issue. A lot of the news reports make it seem a lot worse than that, but needing physical access, well, if they have physical access to your Mac, there's already a whole bunch of problems that you've got. So here's how it works. I'm in macOS High Sierra and using version 10.13.1. So I'm going to go into System Preferences, and then I'm going to go to some place where I need to authenticate. So Users and Groups, I'll choose that. And authenticate means click this padlock to give you access to more things. So I'll click the padlock. And it asked me for my username and password. This should be the second time you need to enter your password, because you needed to enter it in order to get access to your Mac in the first place. But it does this to be extra secure, in case somebody came and sat down at your Mac that has, you know, physical access while you were logged in. Now, you have to change the username to root, R-O-O-T, and password to nothing. And you actually have to click in the field, at least that's what I hear, and then click unlock. And it usually doesn't even work the first time. But in this case, it worked the second time. What that did was it enabled the root user, so a user with the name root and a blank password. Now that that's done, somebody could actually log in using root and a blank password and do anything they want to your Mac. Of course, they're already logged in here when they're doing this, so there's already a lot they can do to your Mac. You already have problems if they're even that far that they could have done that. Now, there are reports that this can happen even on the login screen, so if they're not logged in. So they have physical access to your Mac, but they're logged out. But I haven't been able to replicate that. However, enough reports are out there, people saying you can do that, even though there's at least one major site that says that you can't do it on the login screen. So it's a little confusing. Maybe it's because I've got File Vault enabled, maybe some other things I've got set that I can't do it and a lot of people can't do it. So it's debatable whether or not you can get in if you have physical access but aren't logged in. You can definitely do it if you have physical access and already logged in, as I just did it. So let me show you how you can just completely disable this so it doesn't even work. You don't have to wait for Apple to update a patch, which probably will come out in the next few days, maybe even later today. So let's start over again. You want to just disable this to protect yourself. You're going to go to System Preferences. Then you're going to go to Users and Groups. Next, you're going to click Login Options. Now all this is grayed out because you need to authenticate. So click the padlock and authenticate with your account password. Now that you've authenticated, you have access to all of these controls. The one you want is the Join button. When that comes up, don't worry about the actual join functionality. You're just going to hit this Open Directory Utility button. And this launches another app. Now I could have skipped a lot of this and gone directly to the Directory Utility app. You can run it, you can find it in Spotlight and everything. But most people seem to be showing it this way through System Preferences, so I'll do that as well. Now you're going to want to click the padlock again to authenticate one more time. Now that you've authenticated, that padlock is unlocked. Again, you don't want to do anything here in Directory Utility. You're actually looking for the special commands that are under Edit. And one is called Enable Root User. So you want to enter a password here. So just create a password, make sure it's secure, some random numbers and letters. The great thing is you don't actually need to remember this password. Why? Because you can always return here using your admin password and change the root user password without knowing the original and disable the root user completely. So if you forget the password, it's no big deal. So you write it down somewhere and don't worry about it. Now that you've done this, now that you've set a root user password, now you're protected. Nobody can use this exploit because there's already a root user password set. Blank won't work. So this is the workaround. So just do this if you're concerned. But of course, again, if somebody has physical access to your Mac, then you've got other concerns besides this. I kind of equate this to if you have a safe in your house and you suddenly find out it's easy to open the safe without knowing the combination. But somebody still needs to break into your house in order to get access to the safe. So you can see how it's maybe not that big of a concern that you want to, you know, fix it right away before doing anything else. And Apple's probably going to come out with a patch for this really quickly since it's such a big news item. A lot of big scary news headlines, even though it's not really that scary of a hack.